Hello friends, today I'm going to tell you about internal and external finish lines which are needed in relation to minor connectors and removable partial dentures. Now, wherever there are minor connectors, that is the region where acrylic resin is going to come and it should then bond with the major connector. Like if you see here, this junction where the major connector and the resin base is meeting is basically a definite line. This definite line this is given on a cast framework where this acrylic resin comes and blends with the major connector. This is known as a finish line. Now, in relation to the cast partial dentures, there are two types of finish lines. One is an internal finish line, other one is an external finish line. But if the framework is having a type of minor connector such as the nail head or mesh type, then the base is metal, so you don't require acrylic over that. Only an external finish line would be given in such a framework. So in other cases, like a lattice type of mesh type design, you need both internal and external finish lines. Now, how to get an internal finish line? Internal finish line is given when you have a master cast and a relief wax of 24 to 26 thickness, and this is done before duplicating the cast. So, and on the duplicated cast, you will be making the wax pattern, and once you cast it, then you can you can see that there is space for the acrylic resin. If you see here, one more thing I have done is I have given I have removed the wax and provided, this is known as for tissue stop. So here directly the metal is going to flow once I do casting of this. So this is basically going to provide stabilization of the processes. The function of relief wax is basically to provide space for acrylic resin base to lock against the retention struts which are seen in the lattice type or a mesh type design. Now, another type of finish line is the external finish line, which I was showing you in the beginning. Now, the external finish line should also be sharp and well defined, because and also it should make a butt joint so that you have ample of space for the acrylic resin to come. Suppose you are not having ample of space for the acrylic resin, then chances of this resin getting fractured is very high, or because this area is subjected to high amount of functional stresses, and that is the reason you need to have sufficient space. The butt joint is basically, you need this junction, you need to create an undercut, and this undercut should be making an acute angle, that is it should be slightly less than 90 degrees so that enough space is there for the acrylic resin. At the same time, good amount of thickness of acrylic resin comes and binds and holds the resin into the framework. Otherwise, chances of dislodgement of the teeth and the framework is highly possible. External finish line is formed at the time of doing a wax up procedure on the duplicating cast, whenever we are doing that. And if you can see, whenever you have an adjacent tooth, like here you have an adjacent tooth, this proximal plate, in that junction also you need to provide a good amount of undercut so that this acrylic resin goes and locks into that. Otherwise, chances of dislodgement of the resin or fracturing of the acrylic resin is very high from that region. So this is all about external and internal finish lines in relation to minor connectors and removable partial dentures. Thank you for watching the video.